मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन HTML, दैट इज हाइपर टेक्स्ट मार्कअप लैंग्वेज. इट इज यूज्ड फॉर क्रिएटिंग वेब पेजेस. सो टू यूज दिस HTML वी नीड नोटपैड सॉफ्टवेयर और एनी टेक्स्ट एडिटर. आई एम यूजिंग विंडोज 10, सो आई विल यूज द टेक्स्ट एडिटर नोटपैड. सो हाउ टू स्टार्ट द नोटपैड, यू जस्ट यूज दिस ऑन द कीबोर्ड, दिस विंडो की, दिस वन key and R. That is actually, it will open the run command, and in the run command you have to just type simply notepad, notepad, notepad. Just click on, just press enter button, your notepad window will come. Let me maximize it, and I'm increasing the font so you can see properly. Okay, so now we will start writing our HTML document. If you have not seen the last video I have posted, then you can go first and watch that video completely and do the practice. I am also adding that video link in the description. Please go through it, okay? So you can understand this, the second video of HTML. So let me increase the size of this text. It is very big. 48 size is very big. Let me do it 28. It is visible. So let us start the writing HTML document. The first tag we have to use the HTML tag. Then after we have to use the head section. Inside the head section we give the title of your web page. So let me write down welcome to my website, and then we have to close the tag. Okay, so this title tag we have closed, and then close the head tag. So inside the head section we generally give the title of our web page. Okay, then we will start our body section. Inside the body section we will write the complete content of our web page. So let me write here, this website is for learning HTML. Then I am closing the body tag, and at last let me close the HTML tag. So this is a simple HTML program. Okay, in last class we have already seen this. Okay, for saving a file we have to go to the file option, then click on save button, and always remember after giving the file name we have to put .html, then only it will become the HTML file. Okay, so let me save this file in my documents folder only. So I am giving the file here, file name is J, then .html, and enclose it within the double quotes, and also save as type, just give the all files. Then after you can save this file. Now if you want to see that how it will look in a web page format, so just click on this minimize button and go to your documents folder. Let me go to the this PC, and then after I will go to the documents section, this documents folder. Now here I will search for my file, that is j.html. So you can see here this is the web page it is showing, okay, Google Chrome. So let me double click on it. When I double click, it will open HTML page in the Google Chrome. Okay, let me click on OK. So this is my web page. Now it looks like a simple white background and the black text. So now we can add the attributes to our tags. Attributes are used to add the functionalities to our tag. Let us see how to do that. So inside the body tag, let me add background color, BZ color. So this BZ color is the attribute name. And then put equal to sign, and in the double quotes we write the color. So the color code, let me use red background, and the text color, I am using the white. Okay, so now save the file. just file, click on save button, just minimize it. Now in the web page, you just click on this reload button. When you click on this reload button, the web page will be refreshed. Now see, you can see the background color is red and the text color is the white. Okay. Now suppose if I want to make this text bigger, so you can use the heading text. Okay. So just before the text, we can put the H1 tag, and then here I am closing the H1 tag. So this tag is used to create the headings. Okay. Now again save this file and come to the web page, then reload button. Just click on this reload. So now see, the text is coming bigger. Okay. And then after, I also taught you how to make this text scroll by using the marquee tag. Then you have opened here, then you have to close here like this. So actually the tags are opening in this way and closed in that order, in the reverse order. Okay. So H1 is open first and marquee is open then after, but it will close, marquee will close first and then the heading 1 tag will close. So closing tags we have to write in a reverse order. Okay. So let us save this file and we see the difference. Just again reload it. Now you can see the text is scrolling. Okay. So up to that we have seen in the last class, even we have seen how to insert the images. Let us see today some more other tags. Okay. So today I am telling you first the formatting text, means how you can use the bold, italic, underline options in the HTML. Okay. So for that, let me again open my code file. Now inside the body tag, I will use the text. Okay. Just like we can use the bold tag for writing any text bold. Suppose I am writing here, this is bold text. Then let me close the bold tag. So B is for the bold. Bold means darker. The text will be darker. The next one is italic. I tag, that is called as italic. So this is italic text. And the next one is the underline text. Okay, now you just see this formatting commands. Just go to the file option, click on save button and again come to the your web page and click on this reload button. Now you can see here, this is the bold text, it is coming, and then the italic text, it is coming, and this is underline text, the underline, it is coming, right? The difference is actually, see, I have entered here. Actually, I have written the text in different lines, but still it is not coming. Then we have to use one tag called as BR. It is called as break tag. So it will change the line. And break tag, this BR is the empty tag because we don't need to close it. Okay, like that. So just go to the file option, click on save button, minimize it and go to the web page, click on this reload button. Now you can see here how it is coming. This is the bold text, this is the italic, and this is the underline text. Okay. So these are the formatting text you can use it. Even you can use the superscript and subscript text. Okay. Suppose if you want to show fifth. Okay. If you want to show fifth like 5, then th will be in the upper side. Means it will be the above the base. Okay. Let me show you how it is coming. So let me save this file. Now reload it. So here it is coming how 5, then th is also, but I want that this th should come above. So for that we use the superscript tag, that is used like this, sup superscript. Then we have to close it sup like this. So it will come, this th will come above the base. Okay, let's see the difference. Click on file, save, come to the HTML page, reload it. Now you can see here 5th is coming, and here underline is also coming. Okay, so I can remove that underline. Actually, I have not put here closing tag, just like this, because closing tag is done by putting the this forward slash. Okay, now click on file and save button. Now you can see the changes, required changes. Click on reload. Now it is coming fine. 5th. Okay. Similarly, you can use the science formulas that is called as H2O. Okay. So if you want to write the H2O, that is the water formula, so you have to use first H, then you can use the subscript tag that is called as SUB, subscript. Now here I will put 2, and then again I will close it subscript, because I just want 2 will come below the base, and again the O will come in a normal writing. Okay, so now again click on file, save button, minimize it, and then again come to the page, and here reload. Now you can see here H is coming capital, then 2 again it is coming below the base, and O normal text. So this is called as superscript. When the text appears above the base, it is called as superscript, and when the text appears below the base, it is called as subscript. I think it is clear now. Bold tag, italic tag, underline tag, and the superscript and the subscript. The next, I will teach you how to change the writing and also the color of the text. Okay, so for that we use the font tag called as font, then face. Face is the font name. So there are various styles, various writing styles are there, various fonts are already installed in your computer, so you can check the spelling by opening any processor, word processor softwares. You say like MS Word, you can open Microsoft Word, and you can see the font writings that are installed in your computer system. Okay, and then you can use here the writing style. So let me write monotype cursiva, and then I will give the size 6, and color I am giving yellow. Okay, and always use the attributes value. See, this is the attribute, this one, and this is called as the value, and this value should be enclosed within the double quotes like this. Okay, so this is the font tag I have used. Now here I want to write some message. Okay, just like thanks for visiting our web page. Okay, then I'm closing the font tag. So let me save the file. Let me save this file, and again come to the browser, click on the reload button. So now you can check here, see writing style. Because here I have used what? Which writing? Monotype cursiva. That is the cursive writing. So it is coming like that. But spelling you have to check it. Okay. So here you have to write the correct spelling of your font. Okay. And this font you can get from your Word document. Or even you can go for the fonts folder in the control panel. But this MS Word is easy to open. And here you can change, check the font spelling. Okay, whatever you like, suppose Algerian, or here so many beautiful writings are there in your computer system. You can use the name of that. Okay, but the correct way, just like Broadway. Okay, this is the another font, Broadway. So I can use this font also. So in place of monotype cursiva, let me write the Broadway. Now you save this file. And now check the font style now. Click on reload button. See now the font style. Okay. So in this way you can use the different attractive style for your web page. I hope everyone is clear. And you have to do the practice for the same. Okay. I will also post the code in the description section that you can take it. Okay. But you have to write it by yourself. If any doubt, then you can refer it. Okay. And if any question, you can ask me at any time. Okay. So this, after this formatting text, okay, let me explain there are different type of list in the HTML. List are actually used to write the items in an order, maybe in order or maybe in unordered. Okay, just like in MS Word also there are options. Okay, like this one, this is for ordering, for the order list, like 1 2 3 ABC Roman. Okay, this way you can use it. So these are called as the ordered list, because these are the definite, said after first step the second will come, the third step will come, like that. And one more list, it is called as unordered list. One more list, it is called as unordered list. That is actually the symbols, this one. So these symbols are called as unordered list, and these numbers are called as ordered list. So in HTML also we can create this type of things. Okay, so let us come to the notepad. Okay, and here I am using now, first I will show you the ordered list. So ordered list can be created by using the OL tag called as OL, ordered list. Then you can use the type. Type means which type of things, Roman, ABC, 1, 2, 3, like that. Suppose I want Roman. So this I will write down. So OL type is equal to capital I. So the second item automatically it will come in the Roman second, Roman third, Roman fourth, like that. Okay, let me show you. And all the list items is enclosed, means is written in the list tag, list item. So this li, it is called as list item. So the first item, let me write down HTML, then let me close the tag. In the second I will write, okay, HTML tags. Now in the third I will write table creation. In the fourth I will write image is insertion, like that. And then after I will close my ordered list tag. So in this way I have created the four items in the list called as ordered list. Okay, now save this file and come to your web page and just click on this reload button. Now you can see here HTML, HTML tags, table creation, image insertion. So all the tags are coming like this. Okay, so automatically this numbering is done. Okay, so this vacant, it is coming fourth and sixth. Let us see why. So this is the first item, because here I have not closed here like this. Okay, and here also I have not closed, that's why it has taken one vacant list. Now you can reload it. Now it is coming proper. So in place of 1 2 3 Roman, if you want to change its style, suppose ABC, so you can just here write down A, or small A you can also write. So a small ABCD, like that it will come. So let me reload this file. Now it is coming ABCD, like that. Okay, so these are called as ordered list. You can also use 1 2 3 numbering, that is by default it is coming 1 2 3 4, like that the items will come. And this list item will automatically create a new line. There is no need to write separately break tag, BR tag, because this list item automatically insert a new line. Okay, so let us do now for the unordered list. These are the ordered list, now unordered list. So here also you can use it circle or square, whatever the you want to use the bullet. So here let me copy the same list, but here this time the list will be unordered. Okay, the difference is that much only. So let me save this file. You don't have to remember the commands. Basically once you just practice it, it will all come in your mind by, okay, by practicing. Okay, it is not a hard, the coding is not hard, I am saying, but you have to learn it carefully, with full concentration. With full concentration you have to do it. Okay, let us reload it. Now you can see here this circle is coming, there's a bullet. You can also change it to the square. So in place of type, in the place of this circle, you can also use it See, when I use the circle, so this type of circle it is coming. When I will use it disk, D-I-S-C disk. Let me save this file. Now here the empty circle is coming. Now it will come the filled circle. You can see here now. Now this is C, this one. Okay. In place of this circle, you can also use it square. So the spelling of square. But here the spelling is important. Write down the correct spelling. Okay. So let me see now here. Reload it. Now see the square it is coming. Okay. So this is the ordered list and this is called as the unordered list. So till now we have seen the all formatting text, bold, italic, underline, and then after superscript and then the subscript and then writing the font styles even with the colors, then ordered list and unordered list. So today's work is this only. Okay, you practice this all commands and tell me whether you are able to do it or not. Thank you.